Can't break away, cause you right here. Have me, have me. Oh yeah, I can't stay away. Can't break away, cause you right here. Have me, Lord, have me.
Oh, didn't see you guys right there. I was just loving the land of the free. As you guys can probably tell, it's the 4th of July.
I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up, live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal.
And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country.
Remembering that all the celebration of this day is rooted in history. It's recorded that shortly after the Declaration of Independence was signed in Philadelphia, celebrations took place throughout the land, and many of the former colonies.
I will build a great, great wall on our southern border, and I will have Mexico pay for that wall.
For the 4th of July, I thought I'd give, you know, a little bit of some history about the 4th of July and this country. Well, watch out now. We have a special guest. It's Donna Rush Lusher.
Be careful.
Aiden, this one's for you, bro.
Ow.
They can't hear you. I have the mic on right here. All right, anyways, so let me just get you back up. All right, so some background. 500 BC, the Americans left England because the vampires were taking over. So they came to this country, and they asked some of the nice Native Americans if they could have some of the country. They were so generous, you see, that they gave up all their land of the United States, and boom, that's when it began.
Yeah, That's what happened. Let me do one.
All right.
And then in 500 BC,
all right, anyways, skipping off a couple thousand years, our country was struggling, right?
Yeah.
We were trying to build, didn't have enough people. So a couple of nice African Americans, well, they weren't American yet, a couple of nice Africans sailed the seven seas, came over, became African Americans. And basically, they just offered to help, and they did. They're helping us so much. They built all these things for free, just because they wanted to. All the kindness of their hearts. And then, vampires took over from England, came back here. All right, and they basically take a walk with me. Basically. Donnie Roy, I'm trying to teach history right now. So basically, the vampires took over the Republican Party and the Democrat Party, right? And they took took advantage of those nice African Americans, and they started making them slaves. All right. Then, 1774, Abraham Lincoln was born. Abraham Lincoln, as we all know him as the vampire hunter, he killed all the vampires and then freed the slaves. Mm-hmm. All right.
That happened.
All right.
Happened.
Keep walking with me. Then, my favorite stories, my favorite history part of it, some witches, you know, came from Scotland, basically. And the Americans, you know, we were up all on that. We killed all the witches, even the ones that we thought were witches that weren't. We got rid of them pretty quickly. I can salute to that. Amen to that, brother. No more witches in this country.
Amen, bro. Amen, bro.
Mm-hmm. Then, 1856, Jesus came to America, as you see in the Mormon Bible. They got the dates wrong, though. Yep, 1856. Jesus came and he...
1856, dude.
Yep. Jesus came and he preached the gospel to us, and that's basically the first we've ever heard of it at that time. And then World War II happened. The aliens came down. Master Chief had to kill all of them. And Hitler died. And one of our biggest soldiers, his name was Samson, he killed like about 5,000 of them. And he was a very decorated soldier. Let's see what other stuff we got. Look over here, bro. Oh, follow us. Donna Roy's got a little something to show us. Come on. Come on.
That means hold.
Hold. Hey, come on now. I have some lessons to teach. You see, as you can see, we're in the woods right now. And during the times of the witches, this is where this was their hideout. They hide out in the woods, but not for long after they got brutally murdered. Each one of them got hung, got lynched. Come on, keep going. Now look at that. He's doing the ritual right now. He's scaring off the spirits. The witch spirits still haunt these woods today, but we don't have to deal with them after that ritual he just did. Now look at this. This has been here for 6,000 years. This red band symbolizes freedom for this country. George Washington himself came to this exact spot and put that there. Crazy, right? America. All right, let's move back up. Now, as you guys can see, I have a shirt on right now. It says Freedom Rider. But I actually don't ride motorcycles, but you can bet your bottom dollar I do ride Freedom.
Bottom dollar.
All right, let's just keep moving, folks. Freedom.
Hey,
dude.
Yeah.
Land of the free.
Home of the brave.
Feeling too cold, ice cube. I'm on a roll, dice cube. 10 deep when I roll, I'd invite you. But the click's full, they gon' slide through. The neck is on froze, Cuban link. Shawty look good, gave her a wink. Said I wouldn't last, gave me a week. That made me laugh, had me weak. Ha ha ha, she a freak. Oh, ta-da, look at me. Creme de la creme, that's me. Best of the best, c'est la vie.